Hey everyone, I wanted to go ahead and take a look at the Spyder ETF and yesterday's trading action, which was the last trading day for this week. I want to talk about the market participants and the fact that there are so many different types of market participants. We have value investors like Warren Buffett who seek out undervalued stocks and using fundamental analysis find those undervalued stock and buy them and hold them for long periods of time. We have technical traders, of which I am a part of, and even within this group there are so many different subgroups. There are people who trade Fibonacci retracements or projections. There are people who base on chart patterns. There are people who trade trends, channels, people who use indicators, MACD crossovers, stochastics, overbought, oversold. There are hundreds of different indicators that somebody out there is using. Another big player are the options player. And these are the big guys who do all kinds of fancy combos, iron condor spreads, butterflies, reverse iron condors, all kinds of different combos and strategies. And every player in the market has their day in the market. What I mean is they have their day or their signals to buy, to sell, to take profits, to take losses. On Fridays or on options expiration days, it's the time for the option players to play in the market. And so when it comes to option expiration days, especially on the monthly and on the quarterly, there's a lot of action that you have to take, a little bit of a grain of salt when you see it, because it may not be true to the current sentiment of the market. For example, here, I went bullish on this particular candle because it was a bottoming pattern. And on the next day, we had a lot of volatility due to options expirations. We broke the low of the candle, which in normal circumstances would be a bearish indicator. We also broke the top of the candle, which could be a bullish indicator. In the end, we finally settled somewhere in between. But you had to sit through this volatility knowing that it was options expiration. And it could have made you feel really nervous or shaken out. But this was not the true move of the market. It was just one participant, one group of participants doing their thing. Monday, we had the confirming move that we were heading higher, and we did head a little bit higher before pulling back. So the same thing with yesterday's trading action. And I made the video, the previous video, kind of having a feeling that we would go up for the options expiration. And because we hadn't made a big move, I wanted to talk about protecting the trade, so possibly giving you a better entry, reshorting it based on where you bought your puts or shorted the ETF, or for credit spreads, where you put on your credit spreads. So that's why in the last video I kind of said, hey, if we on the hourly broke this consolidation line, you can look to get back towards this trend line, you can look to reshort it. And even though we had an up day, I really kind of discount option expiration days. Of course, if it moves according to what I expect, it's perfectly normal. But if it goes against what I'm expecting, I kind of give it a little bit extra leeway. If we also look at the up days here, we can see that we're moving up on much lower volume here. The buyers are not coming in. So, even though we had an up day, we clearly still stayed within our channel, our downtrend channel. And so, we hope to continue to stay in this channel in the next few trading sessions. So we had the jobs report come out this morning, and there was a lot of maybe anticipation if we had really good numbers or bad numbers. And luckily we had bad numbers that clearly missed. And but someone asked me going into the report whether I was worried that we would have a good or bad report. And my answer pretty much was, in a bull market, good news I mean, bad news are ignored, and in a bear market, good news are ignored. And, you know, if we had a good jobs number, if we beat the number or met the number and wages were going up, the bears would simply come out and say, well, the economy is overheating. Yellen has no choice but to raise interest rates tomorrow. And the news media would, you know, be all over that and explain, hey, that, you know, we're moving down because the jobs number was too good. And so trying to guess what a specific economic data point is going to do, I think, you know, it's just going to be interpreted according to the current market sentiment. And so unless there's something fundamentally, you know, significant will change everything, I think it'll just play out to the current market sentiment. We've got a lot of issues on the plate. We've got Greece, we've got crazy Putin who might just cause, you know, World War III. We've got oil crashing. We've got maybe perhaps a slower Europe, and more importantly, a slower China. So all of these things are not going to go away just because the U.S. jobs number is good or bad. There has to be time for everything to play out before sentiment changes. So in any case, the ES Mini futures are much lower today. And so hopefully they'll continue to be lower by Sunday's afternoon trading session and into Monday morning session. So my sentiment right now, we continue lower. The jobs will be a good catalyst for us to head higher. The area again that I'm looking at is 204, which looks like it's serving as really strong support here. But that just means once we break it, we will head much lower. So that's it for now. Oh, I don't know if I mentioned it. The volume on today, yesterday's trading action was much lower, which can also be accounted for by a shortened trading week and a three-day weekend. But notice the stochastics. I don't talk about it too much, but the stochastics is still leaning downwards. This lead line here is still heading down. So it's not really confirming this particular move up, which is good for our sentiment. So that's it for this video. If you felt this was educational or you liked it, please click on the like button below the video. And if you'd like to subscribe to my channel, click on the subscribe button and get notification when I get new videos out. So thank you so much for watching. Have a great three-day weekend and spring break if you're on spring break. And see you next Monday.